Right, you're all in here, VIPTV.
What's happening?
Top performance again, mate.
Yeah.
I can't pronounce his name. You were a bit angry at the end there, weren't you? Because he was holding a lot, wasn't he?
The ref's just doing his job, but the kid just survived. And, like, you know, I know he tried to get the lad through the bout, but I thought he should have got the stoppage. The scoreline reflected it, 40-35. You know.
Well, I mean, you had him down in the first round, didn't you?
Yeah, what we worked on back here. I hit my right hand early in camp, so been working a lot on my lead hand, and it paid off because the lead hand hit him, and then he come flying. I hit him with the backhand and come down.
I didn't know what to expect, because even though I didn't watch you, you knocked the kid out in 50 seconds last time, so I never got a chance to watch you.
Yeah.
But I weren't expecting that, mate. You're a good old fashioned style,
yeah,
throwback 50s fighter.
That's exactly why it's perfect at the slam. My entrance music,
Tony Dale, that type of thing. Yeah. You know, it was really.
I'm not like these flashy B kids that are fucking tippy tapping.
No nonsense.
No, that's probably why I never got on there, even though I beat half them. But it's paying off now in the pro ranks and putting people over.
Oh,
he's never been stopped. He's boxed all the best kids in the UK. He's never been put down.
He was almost down in every round, mate.
And he's taking kids to, like, you know, near enough, just a point, and just show they've dominated them. So you just got to let me off the leash in about 12 months against all the top kids. Still got a lot to learn.
Definitely, I think you're going to tear through these ratings, mate.
Yeah, especially at light welter.
Exciting big, though, mate. I can see why everyone talks about you, because, like I say, I hadn't watched your fight before. Yeah. And when I
take a few shots as well, obviously. Like, I'm not like your fancy footwork, but
it's
Ricky good value for money. Yeah, one of my idols. Like,
not a bad idol to be. And if you emulate half with what he's done, it's not bad, is it, mate?
No, I know. I just want to get a big following. Liverpool go the old fashioned route, like I've always said.
Yeah.
But like earlier titles, English titles, and I'm going to follow them that way.
When you look back to the likes of Andy Holligan and, you know, Ocko and all those people, that style, that's
Scouse style, isn't
it? Yes. Fight style, come on. Come on, let's have a fight.
We've got a fighting city, aren't we? So, as long as I'm reflecting on how our city is, I'm happy.
Well, I think this man might be on my face for a while. I really enjoyed it, mate. I know your opponent didn't, but I'll be looking forward to seeing you out early next year then, mate.
Yeah, we're talking hopefully February or March, but then there's a big Sky bill in April, and I hope Eddie Ian gets back in touch with that. Nice one to me, cup manager. There he is, he's always getting in.
Oh, yeah?
All right,
listen.
Nice one, yeah. That's exactly what it was. Fucking hell. He was on a bike for 4 rounds. It was horrible.
Well, like I say, what do you blame him when you had him down that first round?
I've watched him.
His pelvic recovery though was good, you know.
It shows how fit he is. Yeah. And he weren't like just a chump. He'd just been flew over. He was fit and game when he come to win, you know what I mean? Yeah. But once he felt the power, he was on his bike. What I can do.
Ryan, take care, kiddo. Have a great Christmas and a new year.
Yeah,
and
thanks. Nice
see
one.
See you, like you say, January, February.
Yeah, bye, hopefully mate. February.